Thomas McKean was an attorney who held many political positions before signing the Declaration of Independence. McKean was born in Delaware on March 19, 1734, the son of an immigrant Scots-Irish tavern keeper. His education began at home and was continued at Reverend Francis Allison's Academy at Newcastle. Thomas spent 7 years at the academy before studying law with his uncle, David Finney. As a teenager, McKean began his public career as junior clerk in the office of the prothonotary, or chief clerk of the county. By the time he was 18, McKean was appointed deputy prothonotary, mainly recording wills. At 20, McKean was admitted to the Delaware Bar and appointed deputy attorney general and clerk of the Delaware Assembly. 2 years later, he was admitted to the bar of the Supreme Court of Delaware and left for London to continue his legal training. After McKean returned to the colonies, he continued his political life. In August of 1762, McKean was 28 and elected to the Delaware Assembly, representing Newcastle County. He remained in the Assembly for 17 years and was elected Speaker in 1772. In 1763, McKean married May Borden, of a wealthy and prominent family from Bordentown, New Jersey. They had 6 children in the 10 years before May McKean died. In addition to his duties in the Assembly, McKean was appointed sole notary public for Delaware and soon became Justice of the Peace, Judge of the Court of Common Pleas and Quarter Sessions, and Judge of Orphans Court. Although McKean went to the First Continental Congress as a strong supporter of independence, circumstances made him the last person to sign the Declaration. McKean attended the First Continental Congress as a delegate from Delaware. Although he had many other responsibilities, he was a very industrious member of the First and Second Continental Congresses. McKean served on 30 appointed committees and 5 standing committees, including a very important position on the Secret Committee, which established secret contact with other countries. When the first vote on the resolution for independence was to be made, another Delaware representative, Reed, would not support it. The third representative, Caesar Rodney, was quieting a loyalist rebellion in Newcastle. McKean was so upset that he sent a messenger to Rodney, urging him to come at once and break the tie in the Delaware delegation in favor of independence, because McKean was on the list of men who were able and willing to bear arms from Philadelphia. He left the Continental Congress to command troops at Perth Amboy, New Jersey. Immediately after the vote for independence was completed, McKean was in battle and not present for the signing of the Declaration when it was ready in early August of 1776. After the war, McKean wrote to John Adams, "After the 4th of July, I was not in Congress for several months, having marched with the Regiment of Associators as colonel to support General Washington. When the Associators discharged, I returned to Philadelphia, took my seat in Congress, and signed my name to the Declaration on parchment." The time to which McKean refers would have been about January 1777, thus making him the last person to sign. After the signing of the Declaration, McKean became involved in the political affairs of Pennsylvania as well as Delaware. Because there were strong loyalist feelings in Delaware, McKean was not re-elected to the Continental Congress in 1776. Instead, he helped write the first constitution for the state of Delaware and served as the president of Delaware for a short time, although he was living in Philadelphia. In 1777, he became the Chief Justice of the Pennsylvania Supreme Court, but continued serving as a representative in the Delaware legislature. He served in both states for 6 years until his resignation was accepted in Delaware. Although McKean was a strong Federalist when he became Chief Justice, during his 22 years of service, he became more conservative. He became known as a Jeffersonian in reaction to the Federalist foreign policy. In 1799, McKean was elected to his last political position, governor of Pennsylvania. During the second of the 3 sessions that McKean held the governorship, The opposition attempted to impeach him. Articles of impeachment were brought to the floor of the Pennsylvania House, but they were not acted upon. He completed his term and retired from politics. McKean was one of the last remaining signers of the Declaration when he died at the age of 83 in June 1817.